Hello, Ms. Jones. I'm Police Detective Olivia Walsh. Our mutual acquaintance, Edward Schopenhauer, advised me to contact you on a matter I'm dealing with. He said you're the best specialist when it comes to supernatural cases. I need your help investigating a strange car accident near the city of St. Louis. I'm counting on you. Thanks for coming, Ms. Jones. So, this is the scene of the accident. The deceased's name was Arthur Frost. He was the husband of my friend Anna. Unfortunately, Arthur died instantly, so there are no other witnesses or surveillance cameras here to tell us more. We have noticed some oddities in the case. First of all, for some reason, Arthur suddenly moved off the road. Moreover, when his body was discovered, his face looked terrified. And it seemed like he had raised his hands to cover himself from something. The only way to find out anything is to talk to him, and I know you can do it. Don't look so surprised. I've always been interested in esotericism, and I know the spirit of the deceased can be summoned using an object that was important to them. Please, can you help me find something that will work? Yes, that's perfect. Arthur always carried this picture with him. We'll use it to summon his spirit. I've heard that you usually work with evidence from the crime scene, but unfortunately, there's no evidence this time. Perhaps there's another way to perform the ritual? There must be something here that can help you. By the way, take this. It might come in handy.
Thank you. I think I know who attacked me. It was Gregory. But that's impossible because Gregory died a few months ago. Unfortunately, his death was my fault, but I swear it was an accident. I didn't want this to happen. He seems he's come back to our world to make me pay. Maybe he thinks Anna had something to do with it too. I don't have much time left. Please, save her.
Anna must be at home. Please, hurry to her while I go to the station. There may be some materials there to help with the case.
Arthur's dead. Now it's your turn, Anna. You're going to pay for everything you put me through. I'll come back for you later.
Thank you.
Thank you for your help. Gregory was a monster even when he was alive. He never left me alone, and my refusals didn't stop him. The only reason I survived must have been because of the amulet. I was afraid that Gregory would haunt me even after he died, so I bought special amulets to protect me from ghosts. Unfortunately, Arthur didn't believe in them and refused to wear one. Arthur hid Gregory's letters and case files somewhere in the attic. There are instructions on how to find Gregory's hiding place. Find the case files so you can stop him. And here, take this.
Great. These are the papers I told you about. The amulet can't protect me a second time, so I have to hide in here in case he comes back. Please, stop Gregory. And good luck.
Yes, I know the place. I can take you there.
You see, I was the one assigned to the case of Gregory's disappearance, and I used false evidence to convince the police that he had simply escaped. I didn't want my friend's husband to go to jail because of that monster. That's why I'm responsible for Arthur's death, too. Please, help me stop Gregory. We should split up. I'll try to get into the warehouse while you explore the surrounding area. Maybe there's something I missed during the last investigation. Also, I have something useful for you. is where Gregory planned to kill Arthur in the swamp. It almost seems fitting that Gregory's body was left there. I think I know how to get there. My car's a wreck, but there's a boat outside that we can use. I just need a little help to repair it. Here, take this.
How dare you do this to me before I get my revenge? I won't allow it.
There must be things tied to that tragedy around here. They bind Gregory to this world, so they'll help you get rid of him. The power of the amulet is getting weaker. I can't hold it much longer. Please, perform the ritual as quickly as possible.
Thank you.
thank you for your help. They officially closed Gregory's case yesterday, and I resigned from the police. I'm due in court tomorrow. Everyone deserves justice, even Gregory.